Hey guys, this is Amit and you are watching ICF. Today we have the Hop Leo with us, and this is a better version of the Hop Live we reviewed earlier today. This one doesn't get the swappable battery, but it gets more range. So we will be riding this new scooter today and we'll be telling you everything about it. So stay tuned till the end, and if you like the video, please do subscribe to the channel and also hit the bell icon.
So starting with the design first, the Hop Leo comes with a fiber body all around and it gives it a very futuristic approach in terms of sharp creases and design elements. As you can see, the whole design layout of the scooter is much better than the competition. On the front, we get the twin indicators on both the sides. Below, we have the Hop logo. Coming down below, get the full LED headlight with parking lights as well. The overall design is very sharp, as you can see. We have some side extenders as well, where we also get some LED DRLs. Down below, we have the front disc brake with ABS. We also get front telescopic suspension in the Hop Life and Leo both. Here we have the key of the scooter, and we have some detailed cubby spaces along with the bottle holder. The orange marker you see is the cover for the USB port by which you can charge your phone. Up top, we have the digital instrument cluster, which shows the battery range and the speed. These are the quality of the switch gear we have. On the right side, we also get the riding modes along with the parking button and the reverse gear as well to help you reversing in the tight maneuvers. The quality of the side mirrors are acceptable but could have been better for sure. Also, the footboard area of the Hop Leo is quite raised, so taller people can have some problems while riding the scooter. Nonetheless, there is ample amount of space on the footboard area. On the back, we get twin shock absorbers at both sides for better comfort for the pillion. At the very back, we get a halogen tail light along with twin indicators at the sides. As it's an electric scooter, we have a green number plate. To open the boot, you have to flick the key to the other side. And the boot space in the Hop Leo is quite large, and we get the charger as well. Here we have some storage spaces where you can put in your small size helmet as well. Overall, the seat cushioning of the Hop Leo is quite good, but over longer durations, you could feel some discomfort because of the soft cushioning of the seat. As we are now done with the styling, it's time to ride the all new Hop Leo and tell you everything about it. Now riding the all new Hop Leo, and the first impressions are really great. In the city, the scooter feels very nimble to ride, and the comfort levels are also great. Picking up speeds is really easy with the Hop Leo, as the performance is very sprightly. You never feel the urge to get more performance out of it because there is ample performance to start with. Now talking about the suspension, the Hop Leo comes with twin telescopic suspension at the front and twin shock absorbers at the back. The overall suspension feels really supple when you have a pillion at the back. However, at the city speeds, when you are riding alone, the ride feels a bit fidgety and you tend to feel the bumps a lot more because of the light and weight of the scooter. The seat comfort is really great, but over longer journeys, because of the softer cushioning, you could feel some discomfort. Talking about the overall riding dynamics, the Hop Leo stays planted while doing its full speed, that is 50 km/h. However, the steering, as we stated earlier as well, the footboard is higher set. So if you are a tall person, the steering could brush against your knees. Lastly, the Hop Leo comes with a claimed range of 75 km. However, you can easily expect around 60 km on a single charge. Let us know your thoughts about the Hop Leo, and also subscribe to the channel. We will be bringing out more videos on the Hop Leo and other cars as well.